Motorola makes a lot of phones these days, and their high-end flagship, the Z2 Force, is an okay phone, but the $250 Moto G6 is a totally different story. It is one incredibly solid phone, and it's proof that you don't need to spend a crazy amount of money to get a great smartphone experience. I'm Robert Rosenfeld from Techno Buffalo, and this is one of the best budget smartphones that you can buy right now. Let's start with the basics. The Moto G6 is priced at just $250 on AT&T, Verizon, T-Mobile, and Sprint. For this price, you may feel like you're getting a lesser phone than one of the higher-end phones from Motorola, or even some of the higher-end flagships on the market in general. And yes, it's true, you are missing out on some higher-end features like wireless charging and actual IP rating, and the biggest being the higher-quality cameras. But what you are getting on the G6 is a lot of good value. A 5.7-inch screen with a resolution of 1080x2160, a Snapdragon 450 processor, 3 gigs of RAM, 32 gigs of storage, and a 3000 mAh battery. They're certainly not bleeding edge specs, but they make this thing a completely usable everyday smartphone. One of the first things I noticed about this phone is the build. It's a relatively small and lightweight phone, but the smooth 3D glass back makes it feel very premium, as well as it adds a bit of protection with the inclusion of the Gorilla Glass and the water repellent coating. It's got curved edges, which makes the phone much more comfortable to hold in the hand, and I much prefer the build of the G6 to that of the Nokia 6L1, which we recently took a look at. That phone was more boxy, it was larger, it had larger bezels, whereas Motorola's approach with the G6 is to slim them down and make the phone look and feel as modern as possible, and I think they really did that with the G6. That 5.7-inch display is nothing extraordinary by any means, but it is good, and everything from YouTube videos, websites, photos all look fairly vibrant on the display, and the single speaker above the display actually sounds fairly good, and it gets pretty loud. Of course, I do wish there were dual stereo speakers on this phone, but at least the one you're getting does a good job of sounding good and can be easily heard, and it cannot be easily covered by your hand when you're watching something in landscape mode. And below that screen is a very speedy fingerprint reader that can also double as sort of a gesture pad, and it eliminates the need for having those on-screen navigation buttons. You can swipe left to go back, swipe right to bring up multitasking, and press and hold the home button to get Google Assistant. Up on top is an 8-megapixel front-facing camera, and on the back, you've got a dual camera system here with a combo of a 12-megapixel f1.8 sensor and a 5-megapixel f2.2 sensor that's mostly gonna be used to provide depth data and other information for the pretty mediocre portrait mode. This system won't be winning any awards, it's not gonna be topping the charts of DxOMark, but it follows the theme of the G6. It's solid. Give this camera a lot of natural light and it's gonna be like any other camera. It can produce some really good looking shots, though even with just a little less sunlight in the late afternoon, you can start to see a little more noise in your photos. It does shoot 1080p 60fps video, and it looks okay. You're definitely gonna be sacrificing on the cameras on this phone to get to that $250 price point, but you're gonna get a pretty average and, like I said, solid photo experience. When it comes to software, you're not getting the stock Android experience on this phone, but Motorola's take on Android 8.0 is one of the better implementations I've seen, and it's fairly lightweight and pretty close to stock. You're getting some pretty cool Motorola software additions on the G6. Some of them include the object and text detection inside of the camera app, a night display mode that warms the colors on the screen at night, and the hardware and software together in this phone provide a very, I keep saying this, solid and stable experience. The phone ran fairly well throughout my testing. I noticed some occasional system lag, especially with a bunch of apps open at once, but it didn't happen enough to be really annoying or consistently bad. I did, however, find battery life to be extremely consistent on this phone. 3000 mAh is plenty to get you from off the charger in the morning to back on it at night with even some juice to spare. And the phone also supports turbocharging. So if you need a quick little top off during the day or just have a little bit of time to charge, you can get a significant amount of battery life in that short amount of time. Things like the textured power button on the side, USB-C on the bottom, and the inclusion of the headphone jack are little things that add up to make this phone a real pleasure to use. And over the 2 weeks I've been using it, I found that the features this phone does have outweighs the ones that are missing. Though don't get me wrong, I would love to see more RAM, a snappier processor, and more importantly, I would love to see a better camera system on this phone that really provides more solid all-around results. And I know many of you would like to see the latest version of Android on this phone, going from 8.0 to 8.1, and I'd like to see that as well. I agree with you wholeheartedly, and it's something Motorola just hasn't done yet. But I think that Motorola is doing more for this category of budget smartphones than many other manufacturers are. And the Moto G6 offers a lot. And the combination of the excellent build quality paired with the fairly recent version of Android software and all those Moto tweaks you get inside that software, I think that you have an affordable $250 smartphone that gives some really great value for the price. So what do you guys think of the $250 Moto G6? There was an overwhelming number of you in one of our last videos that wanted us to cover more of these budget smartphones. We read your comments, we saw what you guys had to say, and we will continue to do that if that's something you guys want to see us do. Do you think this phone's a good value for 250 bucks? Leave a comment down below and let us know. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Robert Rosenfeld from Techno Buffalo. I'll see you in the next one.